லாஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் மார்னிங் செஷன் 6:30 செஷன்னா தோஸ் ஆர் ஆப்சன்ட் ரேஸ் யூ ஹேண்ட். ஓய்யா ஆல்வேஸ் மார்னிங் செஷன்னா ஐ சீ சம் ஆப்சன்ட் டேஸ். ஓய் ஆப்சன்ட் தூங்கிட்டியா? கேபிட்டல் ரேஷனிங் மே கம் இன் த எக்ஸாமினேஷன். யா ப்ளீஸ் காப்பி இட். ஓகே ஓகே. தோஸ் ஹவ் நாட் காப்பி ரேஸ் யுவர் ஹேண்ட். Okay, please. Write down. Continue writing. Same point. Now, I given enough time. Continue writing. Continue writing. If the intermediary funds, if the intermediary funds are invested back at a different reinvestment rate, if the intermediary funds are invested back at a different reinvestment rate, then we will not be getting this NPV number of, then we will not be getting this NPV number of, then we will not be getting this NPV number of 36,613. Then we will not be getting this NPV number of 36,613. Thus, It is proved that NPV assumes cost of capital as reinvestment rate. Thus, it is proved that NPV assumes cost of capital as reinvestment rate. Thus, it is proved that NPV assumes cost of capital as reinvestment rate. Assumes cost of capital as reinvestment rate. Respond, yes or no? Continue, same point. To put it simply, I'm giving it simply, yeah? Okay, to put it simply, if we discount at 10%, inherently we are compounding also at, please tell me, we are compounding also at 10%. If we discount at 10%, inherently we are compounding also at 10%. Same point, you continue. Similarly, we can understand IRR method assumes. IRR method assumes IRR as reinvestment rate. Stop writing, everybody. Are you able to understand it or not? Now, can I proceed? Now, point number 3 or 4 or 5? Point number 5. How reinvestment rate affects project selection? Point number 5. How reinvestment rate affects project selection? 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 Okay. Now, 1 minute. See, even during copying, I'm hearing noises. And very frequently, when they stop, you start. Now, one thing I'm saying seriously, jokes apart, I have class today up to 4:30. Tomorrow, I have final morning. Tomorrow, I have final evening. All are in this room only. I am a permanent resident of this room. Now, example, whenever you, some of you come early, you'll be seeing me daily here. It or not. Now, understand, I also have some human limitation. I am not a machine here. If you talk, what happens is my BP goes up. You don't clever, my BP shoots up. Okay, because I get anxious. I want to control you. I'll shout more. Yes or no? Due to which, what happens? I become tired. Tomorrow morning, how can I take classes? Don't say cancel, okay? No. Portion has to be completed now. No. Silence, yeah. Remain silent. For you also, energy is saved. For me also, saved. Okay. How reinvestment affects a project? In that right? A. Point A. Shh. Point A. Observations of the two projects gives us. Point A. Observation of the two projects gives us the following results. Observation of the two projects gives us the following results. In point A, right? Observation of the two projects gives us the following results. Put a colon, right? Total cash flow X 1,91,000. Total cash flow X 1,91,000. Y 1,71,000. Total cash flow X 1,91,000, Y 1,71,000. Timing. X gives you cash flows earlier or later? Later. Now big amounts come later. X timing is later. X is like Dhoni. Adapa? Dhoni always goes only later. Romba risky, eh? Maybe one or last. Okay. X later. Y is earlier, like Sehwag, yes or no? He scores from the first ball, yes or no? Y is earlier. Next later, Y is earlier. But this side understood, huh? Can I see? Now. Number the Vetti, Nare match Pakar, can I see that? Now, next. Point A or B? B. Suppose I am dictating right, I'll put the next slide. Suppose, point B, suppose we assume. Suppose we assume a reinvestment rate as low as. Suppose we assume a reinvestment rate as low as 0%. Suppose we assume a reinvestment rate as low as 0%, comma. In this case, suppose we assume a reinvestment rate as low as 0%, comma. In this case, X will be preferred. In this case, X will be preferred. Since this project gives us, X will be preferred. Since this project gives us the highest cash flow in hand, X will be preferred. Since this project gives us the highest cash flow in hand at the end of 4 years. Since this project gives us the highest cash flow in hand at the end of 4 years. Since the project gives us highest cash flow in hand at the end of 4 years. Continue. In another extreme case, say an interest of 100%. In another extreme case, say an interest of 100%. In another extreme case, say an interest of 100%. we would like to go for project Y. Say an interest of 100%. We would like to go for project Y. We would like to go for project Y since it gives us cash flows earlier. Since it gives us cash flows earlier, thereby giving us a chance. Since it gives us cash flow earlier, thereby giving us a chance to earn high interest. Respond, yes or no?
No.
Now, point B or C?
C.
Point C. NPV assumes. Point C. NPV assumes reinvestment rate as cost of capital. NPV assumes reinvestment rate as cost of capital. NPV assumes reinvestment rate as cost of capital, which is very low. NPV assumes reinvestment rate as cost of capital, which is very low. And hence it selects project X. Whereas IRR, which is very high, selects project Y. With this, we all have completed the first stage successfully. Yes or no?
No.
Next. Don't talk. And again I said, the word I don't like in English is what?
Break.
Okay, I don't like that word. Okay. You say, sir, continue is a very good word. Is not enough? Okay. Can I proceed? I'm not hearing anything. Please. Now, next discussion is, before that, first discussion, we saw X and Y having different selection. NPV selects X, IRR selects Y. The main reason is what? The assumption of reinvestment rate. NPV assumes cost of capital, IRR assumes what? IRR rate. Now, if both methods assume the same reinvestment rate, conflict will not be there.
Yes, sir.
If both methods assumes what? Same reinvestment rate, then the conflict will be absent. Okay. Now, let us have some more discussion about reinvestment rate and then proceed further. Now, stop talking. Now, again I say, go home. Look at institute study method, understanding the value of the lesson, nothing of this sort will be given here. Understand that all these are value decision getting in the class. Listen to each and every word spoken. Can I proceed up? Now, sincere, come back. See, this discussion is somewhat a higher level discussion only, but I'll try to communicate. We'll be discussing more elaborately in the final level the same problem with a much more better discussion. We'll discuss dividend policies, etc. But I'll try to understand as simple as possible the next stage of discussion. Both methods should go for the same reinvestment rate. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Let us see one by one. IRR as a reinvestment rate is good or bad? Let us discuss. Okay, now I'll say assumption of IRR for two reasons I will reject. I'll reject for two reasons the assumption will be rejected. Reason number one is project X gives me how much IRR? So look, 22%. X has given 22% IRR. I have identified a project that gives me 22% return.
Yes, sir.
There's no guarantee that every time the project gives me money, I can identify another similar project that gives me the same 22%. That is, first time 110,000 has been invested, 22% return. I don't deny about that, yes or no. But it is far-fetched to imagine that every time the project gives me the cash flow, I will be having another business that is going to give me what? Same 22% return, because this project may be one of bumper project. I cannot expect same type of opportunity to come before me again as when I go for reinvestment. Get up. You able to understand that? Then I give one very extreme example. Okay. I invested 10 rupees. How much rupees? Yeah? 10 rupees. I invested 10 rupees, bought a lottery ticket. The lottery ticket gave me 1 crore rupees bumper. Sikkim Kulkalya. How much rupees? 1 crore rupees bumper. Okay. 10 rupees invested. I got what? 1 crore rupees. Simbra bought IRR is 1 lakh percentage. I went to the bank and said, say, I got 1 lakh percentage IRR. I got 1 crore rupees. Now, take it. Give me an interest rate of 1 lakh percent. Will anybody give up? You know, one time lottery came, y'all. I cannot put the entire 1 lakh and buy all the lottery and get what? Another 1 lakh percent return. That is also not possible. Everybody, yes or no? Now, once a project may give me what? 22%, it has not ensured that every time when the project gives me money, I'll be able to invest that back at what? Such an abnormal rate of 22%. It is too greedy. It is impractical. It is what? Impractical as well as what? Greedy. I can say IRR as a reinvestment rate is most of the time impractical. Except for some bond market, extra where you invest. Everybody follow what I'm saying? Now, you leave about all these issues. IRR very high. I can get that high IRR from this project, but there is no guarantee that every time when the money is received, I'll be able to invest once and once again at what? The same IRR. It is impractical. Everybody, are you understanding it? Now, number two. Second disadvantage of IRR is, I say X cash flows will be reinvested at 22%. Y cash flows at what percent? 26%. It is absurd, because whatever money you get, they will earn me the same interest only. Rumba simple. X gives me a cash flow. Y gives me a cash flow. I take to the bank. And if I invest in X cash flow, what the interest I'll be earning? 22%. If I invest in bank, why? What the interest I earn? 26%. It's absurd. Yes, sir. See, I take a 10,000 rupees to bank. Yeah. Bank says, how you got the 10,000? I say, I got this 10,000 from X. Then I'll give you 22% return. No, I got from what? Y. I'll give you what? 26% return. Absurd. Yeah, correct? Yes, whatever cash flow you bring and put in the bank, whether you steal, borrow or what, beg, anything, yeah, any cash flow you get, the bank will give you what? Same reinvestment rate only. We cannot have multiple reinvestment rate for what? Multiple project. It's conceptually absurd. Yeah, correct? Yes, I cannot say that X reinvestment rate 22, Y is what? 26, because both are money only. Money can give me what? The same return only. So IRR assumes different reinvestment rate for different project. That itself is what? Something illogical or absurd. That is why I say IRR method inferior. Why it is inferior? Because, and the reinvestment rate itself is impractical. It may not happen year after year. Number two is what? Two projects has got two reinvestment rate, but any money will be having what? The same reinvestment rate only. All this makes IRR method inferior. Any point number one? Accept it. Any approach? No. NPV assumes what? Cost of capital. I'll say most sound assumption is NPV. NPV assumes what? Cost of capital reinvestment rate. Reason very simple. When you get 31,000 in the first year, what you will do? Survey is a fund provider. Survey is what? Fund provider. Repay him the money. Yes or no? When I start paying money to the loan provider, what happens is you save 10% interest. Yes, sir. Understand that reinvestment, don't think only investment. Repaying may borrowing an investment. Yes, sir. Enna par, I do not now. See, suppose I purchase a house. Having a borrowing of, for example, some money. Suppose I borrowed for 75 lakhs. How much is that? 75 lakhs I borrowed and purchase a house. I do not. Yes, sir. And every year MTH gives me some money or not? Yes, sir. No, MTH gives me some money each year. Okay. That is like project give me cash flow. My project is education project. Yes or no? No. When project gives me cash flow, MTH gives me what? Fees. What I will do? I'll invest in post office. Repay my loan. The repaying the loan itself is an investment form, because by repaying the loan, I avoid a 10% interest. Yes, sir. The two things, I can use the money to invest and earn interest, or I can use the money to repay loan and save interest. Saved interest is equal to interest earned only, because outflow avoided is the inflow got. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? Now, when I say 1.10 power 3, when I get 31,000 and I compound by what? 1.10 power 3, you may ask a sir, where I'm investing, I'm repaying now, why you are compounding? Very simple, yeah? By repaying 31,000 to the bank, I have saved next to 3 years 10%. Yes, sir. Everybody, yes or no? Otherwise, had this 31,000 not been paid back to the bank, what happens is, there'll be compounding the interest equal to 31,000 for next 3 years at 10%, yes or no? That money has been saved, yeah, right? What I'm saying? Like that, NPV assumes that reinvestment rate is cost of capital. I say it is one of the good assumptions, because any money which a project gives will be used to service what? Cost of capital. By servicing the cost of capital, I'm investing the money at what? Cost of capital only. So the reinvestment rate is 10%. Wasn't quite accepted, it or not?
Yes,
that is why NPV is considered to be superior. IRR, now what I understand is, suppose I get another 22% investment opportunity, then what I'll do? I never repay my borrowing, I invest back at what? 22%, allowing the borrowing to compound. That is also good, but if you get the 22%, yeah, correct? Yes or no? Now, 22%, whether I get or not is question mark, but surely I have an investment opportunity of repaying my borrowing, correct? Now, borrowing is already made, that repayment is 100% sure. But whether you invest at 22% or not is unsure, because it all depends on investment opportunity presenting before me. Hence, I say NPV is the most logical and technically sound capital budgeting technique compared to what IRR and others. Others na kekeva number. When I say IRR, NPV only comparable. Yes or no? We need not compare, because discounted payback concerns only up to what? Comes on up to the payback period. Ignores what? Post payback period. EAB, EAC is nothing but NPV only in another avatar. It's not NPV per annum. PIA, NPV in another form. Colors what? Discount inflow divided by discount outflow. If at all I have to compare, IRR, NPV only should be compared. Both are good. I don't say bad. Both are what? Good. But the best is what? NPV. Because of the reinvestment rate assumption. Everybody, are you understanding it or not? No. Conclusion. Tell me. IRR assumes what reinvestment rate?
IRR.
This IRR, for example, project is what's IRR rate? 22%. Every time I get 31, 40, 50, 70, invest back at what percent? 22%. Tell me, is it logical or illogical?
Illogical.
Why illogical? Number one is, this project may give me 22%. The next project may not give me what? 22%. I cannot be expecting to invest back the money again and again at what? 22%. It's too greedy. Too impractical. Number two, even if it is possible, next say, worst thing is what? X 22, Y is what? 26. Any money from anywhere I get, I'll be getting the same investment opportunity only. I cannot say X can earn 22, Y can earn what? 26 on reinvestment. It is also absurd. So no. NPV king. Tell me why NPV is king. Because it says that whatever money I give, I'll invest at what? 10%. That is true, because already I borrowed at what? 10%. When I repay the borrowing, I invest at 10%. Nobody invests below 10%.
Yes, sir.
I will never invest what? Below 10%. The reason is, suppose new project is for 9%. I have to repay how much? 10% loan. Okay. Will I go for 9% investment? Repay 10% loan? Repay 10% loan. Yes or no? Suppose new investment 11%. I have to repay it what? 10%. Then what I will do? 11%, allow the 10% to compound. Everybody, yes or no? But surely, I will not invest below 10%, right or not? In that case, NPV is very, very realistic assumption, assuming what? Cost and capital, because that's the money I have to repay at 10%. Everybody accept or not? Hence, nothing given, our reinvestment rate should be what? Cost of capital. And which is the correct method? NPV. I should be selecting what? X. Now, don't believe in Y, believe in what? X. You know, Y depends, Y being good depends on 22% investment.
Yes,
26% investment. If that doesn't happen, I'm doomed. But selecting X depends only on what? 10% repayment. That is surely going to happen. Right now, what I'm saying? In that case, nothing said. Nah, when there's an NPV or conflict, without a life disparity, what should you select? NPV. Why NPV is best? Reinvestment rate is logical, realistic, will surely happen. Everybody, are you understanding it or not?
Yes,
but I put but na. What happens is, in this question, they say, we will invest at 10%, 22-26%, 14%. 14%. They said, if the reinvestment rate is 14%, what percent is here? 14%. 20%, another question. They are going to do what question here? 14%. That means, I have some projects or some investments in pipeline that can give me how much percent? 14%. In that case, tell me, will you invest at 22%? Because I don't have 22% opportunity, I have only one opportunity, 14%. Will I repay 10% borrowing? No. Why should I repay my loan provider? I have let him wait. I'll pay him compound interest. I'll just invest in 14% by withholding my loan payment. Yes or no? In that case, will I invest at 10, 22 or 14? 14. If I invest at 14% and again calculate NPV, again calculate IRR, that NPV, IRR, I call as modified NPV. Modified IRR. In a parade or not? Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? That is, when I want to calculate NPV, I should invest at 10%. Yes, if I invest at 14% calculate NPV, that NPV is called as what? Modified NPV, because reinvestment assumption has been changed. Yes, if I invest at 22%, I call as IRR. If I invest at 14, I call as a new IRR, call as what? Modified IRR. NPV IRR may have a conflict, but modified NPV, modified IRR will not have what? Conflict, because for both that NPV and IRR, I use the same 14% reinvestment rate. Enna parida? Did you all understand my discussion or not? No. In that case, if the question gives you a reinvestment rate, I should now calculate something called as what? Modified NPV, modified IRR. Both modified NPV and modified IRR will be selecting the same project. There will be no conflict because both methods use what? The same reinvestment rate. Everybody, are you understanding? No. Yes or no? No. Always this part alone, I'm afraid to teach in IPCC because you may understand or may understand. Let us consolidate. In no time, one can calculate modified NPV and IRR. Most of the steps are already known to you. Okay, now please. Shh. Can I pause here? Listen here. Point number one. Now I'm discussing about reinvestment rate or not. Tell me. IRR reinvestment rate, good or bad? It is having two mistakes. It is very abnormal. It may happen, very happy. It may also not happen. Yes or no? Number two, two projects, two different IRRs may be there, but they won't be having what? Different reinvestment rate, because any money can give you the same return in the future. It or not? Now, next, NPV reinvestment rate is what? Cost of capital. It is good or bad? Yes, it is realistic, because if I don't have any other opportunity, at least I pay back my capital and save the cost of capital. That's a minimum reinvestment rate. Yes or no? But NPV, cost of capital, need not be always reinvestment, because if I have 14% opportunity and my cost of capital is what? 10%. What I will do? I'll earn 14%, allow the 10% to what? Wait, compound it. Yes or no? In the borrower says, no, give me. Nah. I'll raise another loan for 10%, repay him and continue the project. In the right or not? Don't start. He is always asking 10%, pay him 10%, and you are asking 10%. I'll borrow from her, give you 10%, I'll invest at what? 14%, will not raise the project money. Everybody, yes or no? Because it gives me 14%, you are only asking only what? 10%. I'd rather invest at 14% rather than repay at what? 10%. Enna parida not so. NPV is true as long as you don't have a better opportunity. Kadaba? If you have a better opportunity, you should go for what? Modified NPV and modified IRR, change reinvestment rate assumption and then do it. Enna apurinjada? Then finally, the same concept we'll discuss in an area called as bond valuation, realize YTM. You call as what? Realize yield to maturity. The same will be ditto discussed again with more focus on IRR. That everybody, are you following what I'm saying? Now, the concept of say the modified NPV and modified IRR, how to calculate is the next stage. Up to this, following up. Now, I don't put so much detail in the slide, I don't want to dictate. I'll just put the brief discussion of this particular stage. Look at this. When I complete this sum, I promise you, I'll give you the break. Okay. Sure, Appa? Now, up to this, you have written or not? Now, how to resolve conflict? Any correct? Now, first is, as we have found, please participate. All of you read along with me and say, understood or not? As we have found that, don't read, yeah? In how do you read? Understand with me, okay. As we have found that, the conflict is due to reinvestment rate difference between NPV and IRR, we should settle for what? Common reinvestment rate. Isn't that correct? Now, the question is, can the reinvestment rate be cost of capital? Yes or no? Now, it can be. It can be what? Cost of capital. But it is too low. Correct? If I had an opportunity for 14%, I won't go for what? Cost of capital. I can say, it should not be because it is too low a rate to reinvest. One would like to get at least a few percentage higher than the cost of capital. If another project gives me 14%, I will not repay 10. I'll invest at what? 14. Allow the cost of capital to accumulate. Everybody, yes or no? Now. And second is worst. Can it be what? IRR rate. Yes or no? No. Two reasons. IRR is impractical rate for reinvestment. One cannot expect the market to give such an exorbitant rate always. Now, second is what? If you go for IRR rate, the reinvestment rate is different for different project, which is quite absurd because cash flows invested from any project will fetch us what? The same interest. Now, then the question is, then what should be the reinvestment rate? Tell me, what should be the reinvestment rate? The rate at which I can reinvest is reinvestment rate. Yeah, correct. Yeah, okay. It all depends on my opportunity. All depends on my what? Opportunity. No opportunity. What is the reinvestment rate? Cost of capital. That is minimum. Okay. If there is an opportunity, the rate at which I can reinvest will become the reinvestment rate. Innappa right or not? No. So, it is a realistic rate prevailing in the market at which we can reinvest our funds. It is called as what? Reinvestment rate. With that, if I calculate NPV, IRR, I get what? Modified NPV and modified IRR. Everybody, are you following or not? No. So please, let us copy this. Point number, solupa. Point number? 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 or? Point number 6. How to resolve conflicts? Right, first, point number 6, how to resolve conflict. We should complete this sum now, have an introduction to leverage. Okay, how to resolve conflict, other than target. How to resolve conflict. As we have found out that, how to resolve conflict, as we have found out that, conflict is due to reinvestment rate difference. As we have found out that conflict is due to reinvestment rate difference between NPV and IRR. As we have found out that conflict is due to reinvestment rate difference between NPV and IRR is due to reinvestment rate difference between NPV and IRR. Reinvestment rate difference between NPV and IRR, comma, we should settle for. We should settle for a common reinvestment rate. We should settle for a common reinvestment rate. We should settle for a common reinvestment rate. Response, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Point number 6 or 7?
7.
All of you, are you writing along with me or not? Point number 7. Can that reinvestment rate be cost of capital? 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 I'll modify this slide a little bit for you to understand much better. Can the reinvestment rate be cost of capital? Question mark, write down. It can be if there is no better investment opportunity. It can be if there is no better investment opportunity. It can be if there is no better investment opportunity. Everybody follow what I am saying? I don't have any other good project now. At least use this project money to repay your what? Borrowing, etc. It can be if there is no other better investment opportunity. But it will not be if we have a better investment opportunity. But it will not be if we have a better investment opportunity. but it will not be if we have a better investment opportunity. If we have a better investment opportunity. Full stop, right on. If we can reinvest at 14%, if we can reinvest at 14%, if we can reinvest at 14%, why should we, if we can reinvest at 14%, why should we repay capital? Why should we repay capital and save 10%? If we can reinvest at 14%, why should we repay capital and pay 10%? Why should we repay capital and save 10%? Everybody understanding it or not? Now, point number 7 or 8?
8.
Can it be IRR rate? Can it be IRR rate? IRR bad compared to cost of capital, so no. Can it be IRR rate? Can it be IRR rate? In that A. IRR is an impracticable rate. IRR is an impracticable rate for reinvestment. IRR is an impracticable rate for reinvestment. IRR is an impracticable rate for reinvestment. One cannot expect the market to give. One cannot expect the market to give such an exorbitant rate. One cannot expect the market to give such an exorbitant rate. Exorbitant means what? That is very big. Okay. One cannot expect the market to give such an exorbitant rate. Now I hear 22%, every time I cannot earn what? 22%, one cannot expect the market to earn, give such an exorbitant rate. Everybody following a next point B. If we go for IRR rate, the reinvestment rate is different for different projects. If you go for IRR rate, the reinvestment rate is different for different projects. Which is quite absurd. The reinvestment rate is different for different projects. Which is quite absurd because cash flows invested from any project. Cash flows invested from any project will fetch the same interest. Cash flows invested from any project will fetch the same interest. Now, we should go for a common reinvestment rate. Yes or no? Can it be cost of capital? No. Too low a rate. Can it be IRR? No. Reason is given. Then what should be the reinvestment rate? The rate at which we can realistically reinvest. Point number 8 or 9?
9.
Then what should be the reinvestment rate? Point number 9. Then what should be the reinvestment rate? Answer rumba simple. What should be the reinvestment rate? It is the rate at which we can realistically reinvest. It is a rate at which we can realistically reinvest. Everybody, are you understanding this particular concept or not? Now we are going to calculate modified NPV, modified IRR for project X and project Y. When I reinvested, what percent? 14%. That I will do in the class. Okay. I'll give us homework for at what percent? 20%. Yes or no? Don't think that X 14, Y 20. Not so. You know, both are going to have what? Same reinvestment rate only. X and Y I'll do for 14% and you have to do for what? 20%. The modified NPV and IRR. Now, the same point. Point number 9, you continue writing. When we calculate NPV and IRR, when we calculate NPV and IRR, when we calculate NPV and IRR using a different reinvestment rate, when we calculate NPV and IRR using a different reinvestment rate, when we calculate NPV and IRR using a different reinvestment rate, using a different reinvestment rate other than cost of capital or IRR, when we calculate NPV and IRR using a different reinvestment rate other than cost of capital or IRR, other than cost of capital or IRR, other than cost of capital or IRR, it is called, good afternoon. Good afternoon. It is called what? Modified NPV and modified IRR. It is called modified NPV and modified IRR. It is called modified NPV and modified IRR. Enappa right? Now, can you start our calculations or not? Now, I'll complete here. Yeah? Now, please. Now, step number 9 or 10. Point number 9 or 10? 10. Right on. Calculation of, in another 5 minutes we'll complete, yeah. Calculation of, then I have to go for leverage introduction, okay. Calculation of modified NPV and, calculation of modified NPV and modified IRR for project X. Point number 10, calculation of modified NPV and modified IRR for project X. Calculation of modified NPV and modified IRR for project X. Enappa, can I push it on? No. Rumba simple pa. Now, all this calculation you already know. We only want to see that we have known it. Okay. There are 3 steps. How many steps do you have? 3 steps. Reinvestment table, modified NPV, modified IRR. That's all. What are 3 steps here? Reinvestment table, modified NPV, modified IRR. When I prepare a reinvestment table, I reinvest at 10%, 22%, 14%. 14%. That's a reinvestment rate. Yes or no? No. This table you already prepared earlier in the proof with 10%. I'm going to prepare it what percent? 14%. Can you do it or not? Now, write down step 1. In that right, step 1. Reinvestment table. Step 1. Reinvestment table. Okay. Understand that from here only our answer starts. Okay. Inga enna exam la have to write. Okay. Till now we understood the concept. The answer starts from now only. Okay. Step number 1. Reinvestment table. Please. Tell me the columns. Year. Artha kalama solupa. Cash flow. Future value factor at 14. Why 14%? I invest the intermediary funds at what percent? 14%. Compounded cash flow. Call us future value or compounded cash flow. Both are same. Compounded cash flows. Can we start down? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 years. I will do it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Project X. Yellow by cash flow. 31,000, 40,000, 50,000, 70,000. 31,000, 40,000, 50,000, 70,000. I receive 31,000 at the end of the first year. Put in my pocket, reinvest. Reinvest at 10%, 22%, 14%, 48. 22%, I don't have a project. 10% is too low a rate. I have an opportunity for 14%. So how should I rate? 1.14 power 3. 1.14 power 3, 1.4815. 40,000 solupa, 1.14 power 2, 1.2996. 50,000, 1.14 power 1 inverse, 1.14. 1.14 power 0, anything raised to 0 is what? 1. 31,000 into 1.4815, you multiply, what is the number? 45,927. 51,984. 50,000 into 1.14, 57,000. 70,000 into 1, 72,000. Can I total the second column? 1,91,000. No. Can I total the last column? Yes. What's the number? 2,24,911. 2,24,911. Listen here. I invested how much in the project? 1,10,000. And went to where? Singapore. I went to Singapore. I went to what? Singapore. When I went, I said, don't put the money in your pocket. At least repay the loan and save 10%. I say what? 10%. Is what I said. When I returned back, you gave me a surprise. You gave me what? Surprise. Okay. You said, sir, I did not invest 10%. I found out what? Projects with what? 14%. I invested money at what percent? 14%. I'm happier, unhappier?
Happy.
I have been modified. I have been what? Modified. I'm very happy. I'm going to give you a promotion. Yes or no? Because I asked you minimum invested what? 10%. But I invested back money at what percent? 14%. Gave me 4% extra reinvestment income. Whatever. Due to this, tell me, my NP will increase or decrease? Increase. Your old NP is 36,630, na? Your new NP will be more than 36, less than 36, more than 36, because I not only earned the return from the project, I earned 4% extra on reinvestment. Innappa item not now. Now we have to calculate the NPV. That NPV, class, what NPV? Modified NPV. What NPV? Modified NPV. Can I pass or not? Now, step number 2, modified NPV. It's very simple. Step number 2, modified NPV. Year cash flow. Step number 2, modified NPV. Year cash flow. Present value factor at 10%. Discounted cash flow. Year cash flow, present value factor at 10%, discounted cash flow. Anything you observe? When I discount, I discounted 1%? 10%. Because I reinvested 14. Okay. Still for the 1,10,000, the cost of capital is only 10%. Enappa, right or not? Now, always NPV knowledge, the discounted is what? 10% only. Everybody accept or not? Now, year zero, how much I invest? 1,10,000. PV factor 1 minus 1,10,000. 1,10,000. Present value factor 1 minus 1,10,000. Now tell me, did I get anything in first year? I don't know. Why I don't know? Singapore. Second year, did I get anything? I don't know. Singapore. Fourth year only I came to know that the money in hand is how much? 2,24,911. 2,24,911. What the present value factor? 0.6830. 0.6830. It is 153,614. Tell me, what is the modified NPV? 43,614. Modified NPV is 43,614. Enappa, are you understanding or not? No. Why this is not called as NPV? Why this is called as modified NPV? I would have called this as NPV had this reinvestment table been prepared at 10%. Yes or no? After how much percent? 14%. Hence I call as what NPV? Modified NPV. Enappa, right or not? Now, please respond. Now, idamba concept, very simple. But let us understand much more deep and then go for modified IRR. 36,613 the NPV. Yes or no? What the modified NPV? 43,614. Tell me, why this extra money? 4% extra reinvestment income boosted by money to 43,000 or not? Respond, yes or no? Ipdi barba. I borrowed 1,10,000.
I borrowed how much? 110,000. If this project gives me only 10% IRR, my NPV is zero. The project gave me what? 22% IRR. That means I borrowed 110,000. On which I should pay only what? 10%. The project cash flow 31, 40, 40, 20 some number. I'll give me how much, sir? 22%. 12% extra return only generated 36,613 NPV. The reason for getting the NPV, and I borrowed 110,000 at 10%, I invested back at what percent? 22%. I got a 12% margin that gave me 36,613 NPV. Yes or no?
Yes,
sir. It is 36,613 NPV if this project alone gives me money. But what it is, with the project cash flow, I invested how much percent? 14%. Instead of repaying 10% cost of capital, I invest back at what? 14%. They gave me extra margin of 4% or not? That gave me another 6,000 or 7,000 extra. My modified NP becomes what? 43,614. Any no. NP will be zero if the IRR is 10%. Due to IRR 22%, I got how much NPV? 36,613. NPV is 36,613. If the cost of, if the reinvestment rate is cost of capital. Since I invest back at what? 14%. I got another 4% extra margin. I earn how much rupees? 43,614. It is called as modified NPV. Respond. Are you understanding it or not? Now. Next is modified IRR. Modified IRR. Now, please write modified IRR. And then my last step, modified IRR, year cash flow. Year cash flow. Can I proceed on? Year zero, how much invested? 110,000. Year four, how much I got? 224,911. 110,000, 224,911. So, Lupa, should I cash? It is an IRR of a single cash flow, annuity, perpetuity, multiple single cash flow, like an FD. First sum in IRR, 7,500 invested, got 10,000 after 3 years. Yes or no? Like that. IRR of a single cash flow. How to calculate IRR of a single cash flow? Future value is equal to present value into 1 plus R power N. Is one way of doing it. Other way of doing it is what? Finding out present value factor and find out in the table. In number, I don't know. Now. I will do it in the first way, which is easy, right on. Future value is equal to, eduthupa. Slide la, it is done somewhat in a very roundabout way, you leave it. Future value is equal to, we will calculate quickly. Future value is equal to, solluppa, future value is equal to what? Present value into 1 plus R power N. Future value is equal to, present value into 1 plus R power N. Can we do it together or not? No. Future value is equal to present value into 1 plus R power N. Tell me how much is future value? 2 lakh. One number solo pa 2 lakh. 24,911 is equal to what is present value? 110,000 into 1 plus R power 4. Easy calculatable into 1 plus R power 4. Now, 1 plus R power 4. Is equal to, tell me the number, 224,911 divided by how much rupees? 110,000. My numbers are correct above? No. 1 plus R power 4 is equal to, tell me what is the number? 2.04. 2.0446. 1 plus R power 4 is equal to 2.0446. 1 plus R is equal to 4th root of 2.0446. 1 plus R is equal to 4th root of 2.0446. Accept it or not? Now, port to Solupa, what is the number? 1.1956. Is that correct? 58. Auction money is not here. NPV is 1.1958. I want R is equal to 1.1958 minus what? 1. Is how much? 0.1958. R is equal to how much percent? 19.58%. R is equal to 19.58%. R is equal to 19.58%. Everybody, yes or no? Now, that means this R is called as what? IRR. Is this normal IRR, modified IRR? Modified IRR. Because I earned 22%. I earned how much percent? 22%. I invested back only at what? 14%. So it got diluted to 19.58%. Innappa isonum. Now, with this, we have found out the modified NPV and modified IRR for what? Project X. Now tell me, what is the modified IRR for X? It is how much percent? 58% or 59% as the case may be. Everybody isonum. Now, you should do the modified NP and IRR for what? Y, project Y. Can I present or not? Now, point number 10 or 11. Write down. Next. Calculation of 2 minutes. You should be telling me the numbers. Calculation of modified NPV and IRR for project Y. Calculation of modified NPV and IRR for project Y. Calculation of modified NPV and IRR for project Y. Modified NPV and modified IRR for project Y. Now, before is at what percent? 14%. Now 14% only the reinvestment rate, no? At 14% rate. At 14% rate. Stop writing. How many steps are there to calculate the modified NPV and IRR? 3 steps. Name the 3 steps. Reinvestment table, modified NPV, modified IRR. Right or not? Write on. Step 1. Reinvestment table. Write fast. People have to go for lunch. Okay. Step 1. Reinvestment table. I am not responsible for delay. Okay. Reinvestment table. Okay. I came late, but still. Here, cash flow plus future value factor at 14%, compound at cash flow. Now, any money receive invest back at 14%. Year cash flow, future value factor at 14%, compound at cash flow. Compound at cash flow. Can you start or not? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Tell and write. What should write in cash flow? Now, Solubba, what is the cash flow? 71,000, 40,000, 40,000, 20,000. 71, 40, 40, and 20. FEF will not change. Same thing and copy and paste on the previous slide. Okay, it is 1.14 power 3 is equal to 1.4815. 1.14 power 3 is equal to 1.4815. 1.14 power 3 is equal to 1.4815. Next is 1.14 power 2 is equal to 1.2996. 1.14 power 2 is equal to 1.2996. 1.14 power 1 is equal to 1.14. 1.14 power 1 is equal to 1.14. 1.14 power 0 is 1. 1.14 power 0 is 1. 71,000 into 1.4815. Please multiply and tell me what is the number? 1,05,187. You mean as 187? Round it off. 1,05,187. 1,05,187. 40 into 1.2996. 51,984. 51,984. 40,000 into 1.16. Yes, how much? 45,600. 20,000 into 1. No calculator. 20,000. Tell me the last column total. Instead of telling wow, tell me the number. 222,771. 222,771. I just rounded off. 222,771. Step 1, reinvestment table over. Yes or no? Now, step 2, modified NPV. Step 2, calculation of modified NPV. Step 2, calculation of modified NPV. Calculation of modified NPV. Okay, tell me the column headings. Here, cash flow, present value factor at please. What percent? 10%. Always discounted is cost of capital, 10%. And then discounted cash flow. Discounted cash flow. I invested in year 0 1,10,000. 1 rupee present value factor 1,10,000. Year 4 I got 2,22,771.
222,771, 0.6830 present value factor. What is the number? 152,153. Modified NPV. Why I call as modified NPV? I did not invest back at 10%. I invest back at 14%. Modified NPV 42,153. Modified NPV 42,153. Step 3. Modified IRR. Year cash flow. Year 0, 1,10,000 investment. Year 0, minus 1,10,000. Year 4, 222,771. Now, this is an IRR for a single annuity, perpetuity, multiple, single cash flow. Tell me the way of calculating IRR. Everybody, can we start or not? Now, tell me, what is the first step? Future value is equal to, tell me what it is? Present value into 1 plus r power n. Accept it? Now, tell me, what is the future value I am having? 222,771. I got it by investing how much? 1,10,000. At what percent? R percent. How many years? 4 years. 1 plus R power 4 is equal to 222,771 divided by 1,10,000 is equal to how much? 1%. 2.0252. 1 plus R is equal to 4th root of 2.0252. Yada power them. 1.1929. R is equal to 1.1929 minus 1 is equal to 0.1929. R is equal to how much percent? 19.29%. This is called as what IRR? Modified IRR. R is equal to 19.29% is a modified IRR. Everybody, are you understanding it or not? No. Write down. Conclude panlamba. Write down. Final conclusion. Summary table X and Y. Or simply particulars X and Y. Can you start a modified NPV? All of you, what is MNPV of X? Pathu solliya number, what is modified NPV? 43,614. What is modified NPV of Y? 42,153. As per modified NPV, which is good project? X or Y? X. Okay. Next, modified IRR. We have 1 point difference. Okay. X how much percent? 19.59%. Got it? 19.58%. Modified IRR X is 19.58%. Y is how much? 19.29%. 19.58, 19.29%. IRR selects what? X. Modified NPV also X only selected. Modified IRR also what? X only selected. No conflict between what? NPV, IRR. Conflict resolved. Why? Common reinvestment rate of 10-14% has been used. In the parade not now. Now, you tell me the answer. 20% if you do, which will be selected? Why will be selected? Because higher the reinvestment rate, I like the product having the earlier cash flows rather than what a bigger cash flow. Everybody, are you understanding or not? Now, you do for 20 and check, you'll be getting Y as what? The selection of both NPV as well as what? IRR. Is a concept of timing disparity. Everybody, accept it. With this, we complete this chapter called as Capital Budgeting. Thank you. I have not done total fund approach versus equity shareholders approach. In between two sums or three sums, I just left unsolved, nothing great. We'll start with the chapter leverages now. Or help, please. You tell me the time, you should be in the room at the time, don't come late. Okay, now. Since you are very adamant in saying 4 o'clock, I'll say it is 1 o'clock. Accept that. Now, I'll just give you a good lunch break. 45 minutes, we'll start at 1:30. We'll start at what? 1:30. Yeah, that's agreed. Accepted. 1:30, all should be here. Okay, be here by 1:30. Wait. What's the problem? See, 1 minute. I am here without any work, then I will feel very tired, not doing anything. Now, I think I saw some schedules here. 12:45 to 1:30 lunch schedule, Kadapa. Oh, those are difficulty, raise your hand. Why, yeah? I have to go and come back. That means 1 hour I give you. But you have to be here on time. Okay, 1:45.